Keeping fat low for a healthier eating lifestyle. Everyone has heard about the importance of keeping the level of fat in the diet to a minimum. While some fat in the diet is necessary, most Americans eat far too many fatty foods. Fats do play a vital role in the diet, including in the absorption of important fat-soluble vitamins like vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K. These vitamins are stored in fatty tissues, and dietary fat aids in this process. Too much fat in the diet, however, has been linked to high cholesterol, heart disease, and even some kinds of cancers. Eating less fat, especially less saturated fat and trans fats, is an important part of adopting healthier eating habits. For this reason, it is important to use foods that are high in dietary fats as an occasional snack or treat, and not as a staple of the diet. Many meats are high in fat, so it is important to choose lean cuts of meat whenever possible, and to trim excess fat from steaks and chops. Even some poultry can be high in fat, and for this reason, removing the skin from chicken and avoiding fatty dark meat is a good practice to follow. When planning your healthy eating lifestyle, it is important to remember that the fat, whether from plant or animal resources, contains more than twice the number of calories per gram as protein or carbohydrates. Experts recommend that people limit the amount of dietary fat to no more than 30% of total calories. Since fat is so calorie dense, simply cutting back on the number of fat grams per day can result in a significant lowering of daily calorie consumption. That is why low-fat diets are so effective as weight loss plans. Some fats are worse than others. There are both saturated and unsaturated varieties of fats. Unsaturated fats further break down into monounsaturated and polyunsaturated varieties. In general, unsaturated fats are healthier than saturated fats. Saturated fats have been shown to raise levels of cholesterol in the blood more than unsaturated fat. Reducing the level of saturated fats to fewer than 10% of daily calories is a proven way to lower levels of cholesterol in the blood. Meat, milk, dairy products, and eggs are the main sources of saturated fats in most diets. In addition, many baked goods are also rich in saturated fats, since they are often cooked in fatty oils and contain eggs and other fatty ingredients. When cooking with oils, it is important to choose the healthiest ones. Olive oil and canola oil both use unsaturated fats, and they tend to be very useful in healthy cooking. There are even such things as good fats. In particular, omega-3 oils found in fish are good sources of these fats. Omega-3 oils have been shown to have a protective effect on the heart and in the lowering of blood cholesterol levels. Listed below are some of our favorite tips for keeping dietary fat and cholesterol as low as possible. Use fatty cooking oils sparingly. Make fatty foods an occasional treat, not an everyday source of nutrition. Pay close attention to the nutritional labels on packaged foods and meats. These labels provide valuable information on fat content, calorie content, and nutritional quality. Eat a diet rich in low-fat foods like whole grains, fruits, and vegetables. Choose low-fat varieties of your favorite foods whenever possible. There are excellent non-fat varieties of milk, dairy products, baked goods, and more. Choose lean cuts of meat whenever possible, and trim additional fat before cooking and serving. Cutting fat is not easy, but the many benefits of a low-fat diet make it a very worthwhile change. There are few dietary changes that impart as many health benefits as does cutting the fat from your diet. A few changes here and there can add up to a huge change and make a real difference in your health. The importance of fiber to a healthy diet. When it comes to eating healthy and enjoying a healthier lifestyle, it is hard to overstate the importance of fiber in the diet. Even though fiber is most associated with grains, rice, and breads, it is important to remember that fruits and vegetables also contain significant amounts of dietary fiber. In fact, the need for fiber is just one more reason to eat your fruits and vegetables every day. In order to understand why dietary fiber is so important, it is a good idea to know what fiber is and what role it plays in digestion. Simply put, dietary fiber is the portion of food that the human body cannot digest. Fiber is found in foods of plant origin only. There is no fiber in meat and dairy products. Fiber plays an important role in the digestion of food and in the elimination of waste products as they travel through the body. Good sources of dietary fiber include grains, cereals, legumes, lentils, nuts, seeds, fruits and vegetables. As we said before, meats and dairy products do not contain any dietary fiber, so it is important to eat some plant-based foods every day to get the fiber you need. Soluble versus insoluble. Not all fiber is the same, and fiber comes in two forms, soluble and insoluble. All plant materials contain both types of fiber, but some sources contain more of one than the other. Eating a variety of foods rich in fiber every day will ensure you get adequate levels of both soluble and insoluble fiber. Insoluble fiber is important in keeping people regular, and it has shown promise as well in the prevention of some types of colon and rectal cancers. Insoluble fiber is mainly found in wheat bran, some types of vegetables, and in whole grain products. Some vegetables rich in insoluble fiber include carrots, peas, and broccoli. The skins of fruits are also rich in insoluble fiber. Soluble fiber, on the other hand, has shown promise in reducing levels of cholesterol in the blood and at reducing the rate at which glucose enters the bloodstream. Soluble fiber is abundant in dried peas, lentils, beans, barley, oat bran, and in many fruits and vegetables. How much fiber is enough? Many people are unsure just how much dietary fiber they need every day, but most dietitians recommend that women consume between 21 and 25 grams of dietary fiber per day. For men, the recommendation is 30 to 38 grams of fiber each day. Of course, that is easier said than done, and it is important to know which foods are high in fiber in order to boost your daily fiber consumption. In the case of packaged foods like breads and crackers, the fiber content will be listed as part of the nutritional label. In the case of fruits and vegetables, there are charts which show the fiber content of an average-sized piece. Some grocery stores post this information, and it is also widely available on the Internet. When increasing dietary fiber, it is best to make the increase gradual. A sudden jump in dietary fiber can lead to bloating, gas, and abdominal discomfort. In addition, it is important to drink plenty of fluids, especially water, in order for fiber to have the best effect. When choosing breads and cereals, it is best to go with the healthier whole grains. In general, the less processing, the healthier the foods. Eating the skins of fruits and vegetables is a great way to increase dietary fiber. Many people like to make fruit shakes and smoothies that use the skins of their favorite fruits. This makes a delicious and nutritious way to increase fiber consumption. In addition, keeping a variety of fiber-rich foods such as apples, nuts, seeds, and bran muffins around for snacks is a great idea. And finally, eating a wide variety of foods will ensure that you get plenty of fiber, as well as the vitamins, minerals, trace elements, and other micronutrients that make a balanced diet so important. Healthy eating on a budget. For many people, a limited food budget can be a real roadblock to healthy eating. It is an unfortunate fact of life that some of the lowest-priced foods, from fast food value menus to cheap potato chips, are also some of the least healthy. It is possible, however, to create excellent-tasting, nutritious meals, even on a tight budget. The key to planning and creating healthy meals on a limited budget is good forward planning and solid nutritional knowledge. Step 1. The shopping list. Anyone who has visited a supermarket lately knows how dangerous it is to enter the store without a shopping list in hand. Shopping without a sense of what you need and don't need opens you up to all manner of temptation, and most of those tempting foods are not nutritious. In addition, picking up all those extra items can easily blow your food budget and leave you without the funds to plan those healthy, nutritious meals. A good trick is to keep a notepad near the table or refrigerator. Having the notepad within easy reach makes it easy to keep track of the foods you need to stock up on. Step 2. Watch those flyers. Most major food store chains publish weekly sales ads, usually as inserts in the local newspaper. Keeping track of these sales and taking advantage of the low prices to stock up is a great way to gather a cupboard full of healthy food. Once the pantry is full of fruits, vegetables, and other healthy fare, it will be much easier to create healthy recipes the entire family will love. In addition, locally grown, in-season fruits and vegetables are usually more of a bargain than out-of-season or shipped fruits and vegetables. Step 3. Stock up on staples. Essential staple foods such as flour, rice, and pasta are frequently put on sale as loss leaders at major groceries. Stocking up on these essentials when prices are low is a great way to stretch any food budget. Step 4. Never shop when you are hungry. The old advice to never shop when you are hungry is definitely true. Shopping when you are hungry is a sure way to give in to temptation, bust the food budget, and stock up on all the wrong foods. Step 5. Become a label guru. Nutritional labels contain a wealth of information, but it is up to each shopper to read those labels and understand what they mean. Nutritional labels contain complete information on not just calories and fats, but the amount of various essential vitamins and minerals as well. It is important to know how to read labels in order to get the best nutritional bang for your food bucks. Step 6. Pay close attention to package sizes. Just because two cans look alike, it does not mean they are. Packaging can be deceptive, so get in the habit of comparing weights when shopping for canned fruits, vegetables, and other items. Also, take advantage of the lower prices available on store brand and generic products. Step 7. Use coupons, but do it wisely. Manufacturers' coupons can be a great deal when used on products you already buy. Buying something simply because you have a coupon, however, is typically not a good idea. Step 8. Replace meat with beans and other less costly substitutes. Eating less meat and more beans and lentils is a good way to save money on your food budget while still getting the protein you and your family need. Try experimenting with some vegetarian recipes for interesting ways to use these non-meat alternatives. In addition to the tips listed above, there are several ways that smart shoppers keep their food budgets at a minimum while preparing delicious, nutritious meals for their family every day. One trick is to keep the refrigerator and the pantry well-stocked with staple foods. Keeping a good supply of staples on hand will avoid unnecessary trips to the store and also avoid the need to buy such products when they are not on sale. When staples such as bread, flour, peanut butter, canned vegetables, etc. are on sale, be sure to stock up. Eating healthy when money is tight. It is an unfortunate fact of life that many high-nutrient, low-fat, low-calorie foods are expensive, while many nutrient-free, calorie-dense foods are cheap. This can make buying and cooking healthy foods for yourself and your family quite a challenge, particularly when the food budget is limited. With some advanced planning, however, it is still possible to create a week full of wonderful, nutritious meals, no matter how small your food budget. The key is to plan ahead, shop smart, and make the most out of the foods you buy. Planning those meals. In today's busy world, meal planning often means calling out for pizza or hitting the drive-thru on the way home. This type of lifestyle has helped to fuel the epidemic of obesity the country has been experiencing. There is a better way, however. Simply taking a few minutes a week to plan your family's meals can make a lot of difference, both in money saved and nutrition gained. Advanced meal planning is a must for any shopper on a budget. Writing down your meal plans, including the ingredients needed and expected preparation time, will help you plan what to buy and how to cook. For those with especially busy schedules, planning meals that can be cooked ahead of time and reheated is a huge time and money saver. Fortunately, many healthy meals, such as vegetable casseroles, pasta dishes, meat dishes, seafood entrees, fruit salads, etc., are great as leftovers. It is easy to see how advanced meal planning can save you time. Many working mothers, for instance, will make an entire week's worth of meals on the weekend, then heat each day's meals up as the week unfolds. This is a great strategy for creating a healthy and varied menu the whole family will love. Hitting the grocery store. Now that you know what meals the coming week will bring, it's time to hit the grocery store in search of the perfect and most healthy ingredients. Before you hit the grocery store, however, be sure to check the pantry. Keeping well-stocked pantry and restocking when staples such as canned vegetables and fruits go on sale is the cornerstone of any healthy eating budget. After you have gone through the pantry and noted the items you need to buy, it is time to check the sales flyers for your local grocery stores. Most major grocery store chains include sales flyers in the local newspaper, so be sure to check there for sales on the items you need for your meals. Going to the grocery store armed with a shopping list is the best way to save both time and money. The grocery store contains many temptations, and most of them are both unhealthy and expensive. Sticking to the list is the best way to stay within your budget while providing yourself and your family with wholesome, nutritious food. Don't forget to include fresh fruits and vegetables on your shopping list. Keeping fresh fruits and veggies around for snacks is a great way to eat healthier. Preparing the meal. After everything has been purchased, the pantry has been restocked, and fresh bowls of fruits and vegetables are arranged for snacking, it is time to start creating that meal on a budget. As we said before, making meals in bulk for later use during the week is a great strategy for working women and for those who are pressed for time. Taking a few hours to mix the ingredients and prepare the food can save a lot of time in the long run. Of course, for those on a budget, saving money is just as important as saving time. One of the most important ways to save money while still eating a healthy diet is to stock up on those essentials you always seem to run out of. Try keeping a notepad on the refrigerator or near the sink. Every time you run out of a certain food, write it on the notepad. You will probably notice a pattern emerging after a week or two. So the next time your local grocery store runs a special on one of those things you always need, buy it in bulk and keep a good supply on hand. Buying in bulk is a great way to save money on many different kinds of healthy foods. Many people automatically think that the local warehouse club store is the cheapest place to buy bulk items, but this is not often the case. The weekly specials at the local grocery store often beat those warehouse club prices, often by a large margin. So be sure to shop around and comparison shop often as you put together those healthy meals. Smart shopping tips for healthy eating. Any healthy eating plan begins at the grocery store. Learning to make smart choices when shopping for food is the key to the success of any healthy diet plan. Learning to recognize the healthiest, freshest foods is a skill every grocery shopper must learn. Of course, the logical place to start the healthy shopping trip to the grocery store is at the produce section. Most large modern supermarkets have huge produce sections, often taking up a large portion of the store. It is not unusual for the produce section alone to contain hundreds of choices, so it can be difficult to know the best foods to choose. When it comes to the produce section of the supermarket, however, it is difficult to make a bad choice. That is because almost all fruits and vegetables are healthy, low in calories, and delicious. While there are some high-fat fruits and vegetables, such as avocados, they are the exception rather than the rule. The most important thing to remember when shopping for fruits and vegetables is the old saying that variety is the spice of life. Trying a variety of different fruits and vegetables, including some you may have never heard of before. Eating a wide variety of fruits and vegetables is a great way to enjoy a healthier diet without becoming bored. Many new diets fail due to boredom, but eating a large number of different fruits and vegetables every day can virtually eliminate that problem. One way to introduce this variety into a healthy diet is to seek out fresh, in-season produce on every trip to the grocery store. Not only are fresh, locally grown fruits and vegetables usually less expensive, but the changing variety will help guarantee fresh new recipes week after week. Of course, the produce section is not the only place to find healthy, nutritious foods. The other parts of the supermarket are also full of both good and bad choices. For instance, when choosing bread, it is best to buy whole grain breads and avoid the more processed varieties. The same is true of baked goods. Whole grain products contain large amounts of fiber and other nutrients that the more refined baked goods may lack. Important healthy eating decisions need to be made in the meat section of the grocery store as well. This means buying the leanest cuts of meat you can find. In addition, extra fat should be trimmed at home, or better yet, have the butcher do it at the store. After all, why pay extra for what you don't use? Even though poultry is generally low fat, not all poultry is created equal. Some varieties, like duck and goose, contain significant amounts of fat. A roast goose or duck can be great for Christmas or other special occasions, but these meats are generally too greasy to be used for everyday meals. Even low-fat poultry like chicken breasts can benefit from some additional trimming. Removing the skin from chicken significantly cuts the amount of fat and calories it contains. In addition, using low-fat white meat chicken instead of fattier dark meat is a smart move. When buying ground meats, always try to buy the leanest varieties you can afford. Ground beef that is 97% lean is a good choice. In addition, ground turkey or ground chicken makes a good lower-fat substitute for ground beef, and it can be used in all recipes that call for ground beef, including tacos, burritos, barbecue, burgers, etc. One important note about ground turkey and ground chicken, however. Processed ground poultry products can often contain surprisingly high levels of fat. That is because manufacturers often grind up unwanted skin and fat in addition to the lean turkey or chicken. This is a particular problem with lower-priced varieties of ground chicken and turkey, so it pays to read the labels and monitor fat content carefully. Learning to be a smart shopper is a vital part of enjoying a healthy lifestyle. No matter what your reason for eating healthy, learning to shop smart and buy healthy foods is an essential first step. Healthy eating and dining out. One of the biggest challenges facing those trying to follow a healthy diet is the local restaurant. Eating out presents special challenges, such as not knowing how the food was prepared, how much fat it contains, and whether or not the healthiest ingredients were used. Many restaurant chains and even some fast food restaurants have recognized the demand for healthier menu choices, and they are working hard to satisfy that demand. All too often, however, the healthy choices on a restaurant menu are limited and unappealing. It is important, therefore, to pay close attention to the menu and make the healthiest choices possible. One of the most important things diners can do to eat healthy at restaurants is to be proactive. Diners should not be afraid to ask how a dish is prepared or what ingredients are used in its preparation. If the server does not know, ask him or her to check with a chef. A good chef will be happy to answer such questions and to make modifications in the recipe if needed. In addition, most restaurants will happily accommodate special needs, such as low-fat or low-sodium dishes. After all, the restaurant is here to serve its patrons. Some of our favorite tips for healthy eating in restaurants include: one good rule of thumb to use when dining out is to order entrees that are grilled, baked, or broiled. Deep-fried dishes are best avoided. If you are unsure how a dish is prepared, don't be afraid to ask. Portion size is just as important at the restaurant as they are at home. That means ordering the petite filet instead of the full-size steak, requesting half-size portions of French fries, and maybe even foregoing that tempting dessert. Choosing leaner cuts of meat or fish is also a good way to eat healthier. When choosing side dishes, ask if steamed vegetables are available. Steamed vegetables are an excellent low-fat, low-calorie choice for many diners. Vegetables that are fried, au gratin, or prepared in cream or butter sauces are best avoided. When ordering salad, ask if fat-free choices are available. Most restaurants have several fat-free or low-fat varieties of salad dressing available. If no low-fat option exists, request the dressing on the side so that you can control the amount that is used. When ordering soup, choose broth-based soups and avoid bisques or rich soups like cream of crab or cream of broccoli. A simple vegetable soup is a delicious and low-fat alternative. Replace high-fat, high-calorie French fries with healthier alternatives, such as fresh fruit or an unbuttered baked potato. Most restaurants will be happy to accommodate such special requests. In Italian restaurants, stick with the tomato-based sausages and avoid cream or heavy Alfredo sauces. A simple pesto sauce without meat is a good choice for most pasta dishes. When dining at Oriental restaurants, go with the steamed rice and stir-fried vegetable entrees. Avoid the heavy sauces and request that your meal be prepared with less oil. In addition, try to choose dishes that feature less meat and more fresh vegetables. Choose a light dessert of fresh fruit or sorbet. When ordering traditional desserts, order one and share it with your dining partner. Finally, when dining at a fast food restaurant, it is important to avoid the temptation of supersizing the meal. Fast food restaurants often make their larger portions more attractive by pricing them competitively, but a big part of healthier eating is to control portion sizes. In addition, most fast food chains now offer healthier alternatives, such as salads and baked potatoes, as well as prominently displayed nutritional information. While dining out certainly presents challenges to those trying to enjoy a healthy lifestyle, there is no reason to forego the pleasure of an occasional meal out. By following the guidelines listed above, and by adding some creative tips of your own, you can make dining out a healthy experience as well as a pleasant one. Choosing the best meat for healthy eating. Choosing the right meat and poultry products can be one of the most difficult parts of cooking and eating for better health. Meat, seafood, and poultry are important sources of protein, iron, vitamins, and minerals, but they are often laden with undesirable qualities such as saturated fat and cholesterol as well. Choosing the best, leanest cuts of meat is important to any conscious shopper. One of the most important things to know when choosing meat, seafood, and poultry products is that less is often more. That means buying meat, seafood, and poultry products that have been processed as little as possible. The past few years have seen quite a jump in the number of convenience foods, but these foods are often much less healthy than their fresh meat counterparts. One of the reasons why this is so is the need for preservatives, sodium, and other additives. Foods that are frozen, microwavable, or ready to eat often contain large amounts of sodium, often more than you need in several days. While it is fine to keep a couple of these convenient foods on hand for quick meals, they cannot form the basis of a healthy eating lifestyle. Fresh meat, seafood, and poultry, on the other hand, does not suffer from the need to add sodium or preservatives. Buying fresh meats and seafood and preparing it yourself is the best way to have confidence in the nutritional quality of the food you feed your family. Of course, no discussion of fresh meat is complete without a note or two about safe handling techniques. Foodborne illnesses can easily be spread through contaminated meat, poultry, and seafood, and it is impossible to tell from looking if the product is contaminated. Since cooking to the proper temperature destroys these foodborne pathogens, the most important thing is to keep raw meat and poultry away from foods that will not be cooked. That means keeping things like salad bowls and bread plates well away from the area of the countertop where the meat is prepared. Any surface touched by raw meat, seafood, or poultry should be thoroughly cleaned with an antibacterial solution, and separate cutting boards should be used for vegetables and meats. Following these basic food hygiene practices is the best way to protect yourself and your family from foodborne illnesses. Cutting the fat is also an important consideration when it comes to choosing meat, seafood, and poultry. While most types of fish are healthy and low fat, some fish, such as salmon, can have significant fat content. Again, the nutritional label should be your guide. When it comes to chicken, the best course of action is to buy skinless, boneless chicken breasts. This type of poultry is healthy, convenient, and easy to use. And best of all, skinless, boneless chicken breasts are often on sale, so stock up on them when your local grocery store runs its next promotion. A good alternative for those with the time is to buy regular chicken breast and remove the skin and bone yourself. This is often a less expensive alternative than buying the boneless, skinless chicken breast. Ground turkey can be an excellent and lower-fat alternative to ground beef, but again, it is important to read the label carefully. That is because ground turkey, particularly the less expensive brands, often contain skin and fat along with the lean meat. Ground turkey breast or a brand with lower fat content can be a healthier alternative. Ground turkey breast can be used in any recipe that calls for ground beef, including burritos, barbecue, tacos, chili, and even hamburgers on the grill. And of course, eating healthy does not mean giving up delicious foods like beef and pork. Lean cuts of beef and pork can be an important part of a healthy diet. Beef and pork are both excellent sources of iron, zinc, and B-complex vitamins, and properly prepared, lean beef and pork are nutritious as well as delicious. And finally, there are a number of lower-fat, healthier alternatives to beef and pork. Meats like buffalo, venison, and emu are much lower in fat than beef, while providing the same or even higher levels of protein. The downside of these exotic meats, of course, is the price, but if you can find a local supply at a good price, they are definitely worth a look. Choosing the leanest cuts of meat for healthy eating. Choosing the right cuts of meat is one of the most difficult things to do when following a healthy lifestyle. Meat can be among the most calorie and fat-dense foods, and it is not always easy to spot the leanest cuts of meat in the butcher's case. It is important, however, to choose lean cuts of meat when cooking healthy dishes. Even the lowest fat meal can be sabotaged by an addition of a high-fat pork chop, roast, or other cut of meat. Of course, it is still possible to include meat in a healthy diet. There are many lean cuts of meat available at the local grocery store, and meat provides much-needed protein for energy and muscle development. The key to buying the leanest cuts of meat for your healthy diet is to examine the cuts of meat carefully and to have any additional fat trimmed. In cases where the grocery store has its own butcher, this is a relatively easy process. Most in-store butchers are happy to show customers the various cuts of meat and to trim the meat to their specifications. In the case of grocery stores where all the cuts of meat are pre-packaged, choosing the leanest cuts is often more difficult. Meat is often packaged to conceal the fat, so additional trimming may need to be done once the meat is purchased. It is important, however, to trim meat carefully, no matter where it is purchased. Trimming the extra fat off the meat you cook is very important when preparing healthy meals for yourself and your family. Shopping for good cuts of poultry is much easier than finding the leanest cuts of meat. That is because the most common poultry products, such as chicken and turkey, are naturally low fat. There are high-fat varieties of poultry, such as goose and duck, but these are not served on a regular basis in most homes. The biggest problem poultry shoppers face is the calories and fat added by chicken and turkey skin. Most grocery stores sell skinless varieties of chicken breast, and these can be a great time saver. If the skinless varieties are a lot more expensive, however, it may be more cost-effective to buy the cheaper cuts and remove the skin yourself. Like poultry, most varieties of seafood are naturally low in fat. Salmon is probably the best-known exception to this rule. Salmon is fatty for fish, but still much leaner than many cuts of meat. Most varieties of fish, however, are naturally lean and very healthy. As a matter of fact, those striving to follow a healthy diet should try to add more fish and seafood to their diet. Fish is very high in protein and low in fat and relatively low in calories. This is a valuable combination for any one food. As with many aspects of smart food shopping, when it comes to meat, poultry, and seafood, fresher is better. There are a number of prepackaged, ready-to-heat-and-eat varieties of meat, seafood, and chicken at the local grocery store. While these products can be fine for an occasional quick meal or snack, they should not form the basis of a healthy diet. The reason for this is simple. Processing meats, seafood, and poultry often involves the use of unhealthy additives, such as preservatives and sodium. Check the sodium level of any processed meat products you buy, and use such products only occasionally. While buying fresh meat, seafood, and poultry products is best, it is important to handle such foods properly on their journey from the grocery store to the dinner table. Improper food handling is responsible for the vast majority of foodborne illness in the United States, and it is important to handle any raw meat, seafood, or poultry product carefully. Probably the most important part of food handling safety is making sure that foods that are not cooked, such as salads and bread, do not come in contact with raw meat, poultry, or seafood. Most foodborne pathogens are killed during the cooking process, but they can easily spread to salads and other uncooked foods if care is not used. That means scrubbing countertops carefully with an antibacterial product, using separate cutting boards for meats and vegetables, and of course washing your hands thoroughly after handling meat, poultry, or seafood products. Avoiding fat for healthier eating. While some fat in the diet is necessary, and it would be a mistake to try to eliminate all fat from the diet, most people simply eat too much fat. Cutting back on fat is an important part of creating a healthier diet and lifestyle. There are a number of good reasons for cutting back on levels of dietary fat. Those reasons include: lowering levels of dietary fat helps in weight loss and weight management. Fat contains twice as many calories per gram as protein and carbohydrates, so eating less fat usually means consuming fewer calories. Lowering fat has been shown to decrease the risk of heart disease. Dietary fat, particularly saturated fat, has been implicated as a factor in heart disease and elevated cholesterol levels. A low-fat diet may help to reduce the risk of some forms of cancer. Although this matter has not been totally settled, there have been a number of studies which indicate that a diet low in fat can keep certain cancers at bay. And of course, eating fewer high-fat foods means that you will be able to enjoy many more low-fat alternatives, such as vegetables, fruits, and whole grains. Since these types of foods tend to be nutrient-rich and low-calorie, they can be enjoyed guilt-free. Of course, cutting back on dietary fat is easier said than done, so we have compiled a list of tips for low-fat, healthy eating to help you get started. In place of spreads like peanut butter and full-fat cream cheese, use lower-fat alternatives such as low-fat cream cheese, jellies, jams, fruit spreads, apple butter, mustard, low-fat margarine, or low-fat mayonnaise. Use high-fat foods as an occasional treat, not as a dietary staple. Use reduced-fat or non-fat salad dressings whenever possible. When eating out, request the salad dressing on the side so you can compare the amount used. Instead of butter or sour cream, top baked potatoes with plain non-fat or low-fat yogurt. Other delicious baked potato toppings include steamed broccoli, cottage cheese, salsa, low-fat cheese, and low-fat or non-fat sour cream. Get creative with seasonings to add flavor without adding fat or calories. Garnishes like lemon juice, herbs, salsa, or green onions are great toppings for vegetables and salads. Use high-fat toppings sparingly. For instance, instead of using a tablespoon of blue cheese salad dressing, try using only a teaspoon. Avoid full-fat dairy products whenever possible. Using skim milk or 2% milk instead of whole milk can make a huge difference in your daily fat intake. Likewise, low-fat alternatives to ice cream, such as frozen yogurt, provide all the flavor and none of the fat. Low-fat cheeses also provide a great alternative to full-fat varieties. Most varieties of hard cheeses are available in low-fat versions. Use low-fat varieties of popular snacks. Ginger snaps, angel food cake, vanilla wafers, fig bars, jelly beans, hard candy, and gumdrops are all excellent choices for a sweet treat. Instead of potato chips, which are very high in fat, choose pretzels, unbuttered popcorn, and other healthier alternatives. In addition to choosing the right foods, the preparation of the foods you buy is very important to keeping fat levels as low as possible. Proper low-fat food preparation starts with buying the leanest cuts of beef, pork, fish, and chicken, and removing the skin and fat from chicken breasts, legs, and thighs. Broiling, baking, and grilling are generally the lowest fat methods for preparing the meats and seafood you buy. Try to avoid frying foods, and if you must fry, try to use a pan that allows the excess fat and oil to drain off easily. Healthy, low-fat cooking does not have to be boring or unappetizing. There are a great many excellent recipes for low-fat, healthy meals that are easy to make. The most important thing is to be an educated consumer and shop carefully for the healthiest produce, meat, and seafood. Healthier, low-fat eating. Avoiding high levels of fat is important to just about everyone these days. High levels of dietary fat and cholesterol have been implicated in heart disease, stroke, diabetes, and even some types of cancers. Staying healthy often means cutting back on fat. The trick is to do this without sacrificing the taste you and your family crave. There are many good reasons for cutting back on the amount of fat in the diet. The average diet today contains far too much fat, and lowering the level of fat in the diet is a great help for losing weight and gaining fitness. Since fat contains more than twice as many calories as protein or carbohydrates, cutting back on fat usually means a reduction in caloric intake. In addition to its usefulness in losing weight, cutting levels of fat in the diet is also important to long-term good health. High fat in the diet can lead to high cholesterol levels, hardening of the arteries, obesity, diabetes, and other serious medical complications. In addition, high dietary fat is thought to play a role in the development of some of the most common cancers. In addition, cutting back on high-fat foods will allow you to enjoy more of other, healthier foods. Enjoying more wholesome, healthy foods like vegetables, fruits, and whole grains while cutting back on greasy, fatty foods is a great way to enjoy a healthy lifestyle. Cutting back on the amount of fat in the diet is not always easy, however, especially for those who have never had to worry about fat content before. There are a number of simple, easy changes you can make, however, that will allow you to enjoy a low-fat lifestyle with little sacrifice. For instance, when enjoying toast, bagels, and other whole grain products, don't use peanut butter or cream cheese, which are high in fat. For a low-fat alternative, spread toast, bread, and bagels with jelly, jams, apple butter, low-fat cream cheese, or low-fat margarine. Eating a healthier, lower-fat diet often means changing your relationship with high-fat foods. That means enjoying high-fat foods like bacon and sausage as an occasional treat or garnish, instead of as a staple of the diet. Eating healthy naturally means eating more salads, but it is important not to wreck the healthy effects of the salad by loading them down with high-fat dressings. A salad tricked out with blue cheese dressing, for instance, can easily contain more fat and calories than a hamburger. That is why it is important to keep a supply of low-fat or non-fat dressings on hand. When eating at your favorite restaurant, ask for non-fat dressing, or get the dressing on the side so you can control the amount used. Baked potatoes are another healthy alternative, but like salads, they can be sabotaged by the addition of high-fat dressings. Instead of using butter, margarine, cheese, or sour cream, try topping baked potatoes with plain non-fat yogurt, salsa, cottage cheese, or steamed broccoli. And don't forget to eat the potato skin for extra nutrients. The skins of baked potatoes are great sources of fiber and vitamins. When using seasonings, there are a number of great garnishes that add zest and flavor without adding calories. Additions like lemon juice, salsa, herbs, and green onions are great additions to salads and stir-fried vegetables. You're probably seeing a pattern here. Toppings can be great when used wisely, but the wrong toppings can quickly add fat and calories to even the lowest fat recipe. Use high-fat toppings sparingly and try to find low-fat and non-fat alternatives whenever possible. There are a great many low-fat and non-fat products on the market, and these products make it easier than ever to eat healthy while still enjoying your favorite foods. Some of the best low-fat and non-fat foods are found in the dairy case, including low-fat and non-fat milk, cheese, and even ice cream. Many popular snacks, including cakes, cookies, and even potato chips, are available in non-fat and low-fat varieties as well. Care should be used, however, with such products. Some of these baked goods and salty snacks have very high levels of sugar, sweeteners, salt, and other unhealthy ingredients. As with all snacks, low-fat cakes, cookies, and chips should be an occasional treat only. Instead, snack on fresh fruit like apples, oranges, and bananas. How to cook for a healthier you. When it comes to healthy eating, sometimes how you cook is just as important as what you eat. There are definitely healthy and less healthy ways to prepare the healthy foods you buy. When it comes to cooking vegetables, it is always best to use as little water as possible. That is because overcooking, especially when boiling, can destroy some of the important nutrients that make vegetables so important. The best way to cook most vegetables in the microwave, preferably in a special microwave vegetable steamer. Vegetables can also be lightly cooked in a microwave-safe bowl using as little water as possible. Vegetables can be cooked on the stovetop as well, but it is important to use as little water as possible when boiling vegetables. Vegetables like broccoli and Brussels sprouts are particularly susceptible to losing important nutrients. Microwave ovens are also great for making other vegetables, especially baked potatoes. Baked potatoes get great in the microwave, with the skins getting nice and crispy and the flesh being very tender. Of course, this means that less high-fat toppings may be needed, so the microwave is a great way to make nutritious and delicious baked potatoes. Grilling is another great way to make healthy, delicious meals. Grilling meats is a great low-fat way to prepare meals, and it is a great way to make vegetables and fruits as well. Vegetable kebabs are great on the grill, whether combined with lean cuts of meat or made into a meal of their own. Your oven's broiler is another great way to create low-fat meals. Broiling is a great way to prepare all kinds of meals and seafood, and broiling is a low-fat cooking method as well. Broiling fish is a great, fast, and easy way to prepare this staple of a healthy, low-fat diet, while broiling steaks and chops keep fat at a minimum while keeping taste at its highest. The handy kitchen blender is another great way to create delicious snacks using healthy fruits and vegetables. Blenders are great for making fruit smoothies, and most recipes call for little more than crushed ice, fruit juice, and fresh fruit. Some great high-nutrition, low-fat, low-calorie meals require no preparation at all. For instance, it is possible to make a wonderful and easy fruit salad with just a can of mandarin oranges, an apple, some strawberries, and a banana. Simply open the can of mandarin oranges, empty it into a bowl, along with the juice it is packed in. Then add banana slices, apple slices, and strawberries. For extra color and taste, add some blueberries, raspberries, or raisins. The total prep time for this great creation is all of 5 minutes. Fruit skewers are another creative, healthy, and easy meal or snack. Simply take shish kebab skewers and stack them full of melon slices, strawberries, red grapes, white grapes, and chunks of pineapple. Plain non-fat yogurt makes an excellent and low-fat dip. In addition to the above ideas, making your own homemade salsa is a great way to create a low-fat alternative to sour cream and other high-fat dips. Salsa can be made using healthy ingredients like tomatoes, mangoes, avocados, onions, cilantro, and lime juice. In addition, perking up a plain salad is a great way to add even more fruits and vegetables to an already healthy diet. For example, use broccoli florets, carrot slices, slices of cucumber, green peppers, red peppers, and bean sprouts to add color, zest, and flavor to any salad. Cucumbers, green peppers, broccoli, and carrots are also great additions to pasta salads and potato salads. Adding extra crunch and color is a great way to add zest to any meal or snack. Even a plain green salad of lettuce and tomatoes can be enhanced through the use of colorful fruits and vegetables. Adding vegetables like carrots, bean sprouts, and spinach leaves, and fruits like mandarin oranges, apple slices, nectarine slices, grapes, apple slices, pineapples, and raisins adds both beauty and taste to any salad. Of course, salad dressing is always an important subject for those trying to follow a healthy lifestyle. High-fat dressing can sabotage even the healthiest salad, but there are many excellent, low-fat, and healthy choices when it comes to topping a salad. Using flavored vinegars, herbs, and fruit juices are novel approaches to salad dressing, in addition to the many non-fat and low-fat versions of commercial salad dressing. Healthy cooking for those with little time. Everyone who has ever juggled home, family, and kids knows how difficult it is to create healthy meals when pressed for time. Cooking healthy, delicious meals can be difficult, but some advanced planning can allow you to make the most of your cooking time. One way to cook healthy meals that are easy to prepare is to plan your meals around several key foods that can be prepared in large quantities and used in several different recipes on consecutive nights. This method of making meals last is totally different from the usual strategy of making a huge batch of food and living on leftovers for the rest of the week. Your family will certainly appreciate the difference. There are some key elements to cooking this way. The first step is to promptly separate and refrigerate the portion that will be used for the next day's meal before you place tonight's meal on the table. Refrigerating the unused portion of the prepared meal is important to preventing foodborne illnesses, especially when serving meat, poultry, seafood, or any meal containing eggs or dairy products. The foods that have been prepared ahead of time should be stored in shallow containers to allow it to cool more quickly in the refrigerator. Thicker foods, like stews, puddings, and meat slices, should be stored in bowls no deeper than 2 inches. The food should be stirred occasionally as it cools. The leftover refrigerated foods should be used within 1 or 2 days. If the food is to be stored longer than that, it should be frozen for later use and thawed overnight in the refrigerator. Thawing food at room temperature should be avoided, since it can be a gateway to foodborne illnesses and other pathogens. One of the easiest examples of the leftover strategy is chicken breast or turkey cutlets. Poultry works great for this strategy since it is easy to cook large quantities. Start by cooking extra chicken breast or turkey cutlets. Half of the chicken or turkey should be refrigerated overnight for use the next day. The remaining half can be topped with your favorite spices, sauces, and seasonings and served right away. The brilliance of this strategy will become apparent the next evening when the other half of the turkey or chicken can be used in an entirely different way. One great way to use the other half is to cut it into strips, add lettuce and salad dressing, and to create a delicious Caesar salad. Thus, one staple food becomes 2 delicious and totally different meals. Rice is another great staple that works well for planned ahead meals. The rice dishes start with cooking and preparing a large quantity of rice. While the rice is cooking, add some ground beef or ground turkey to tomato sauce and flavor it with some Italian seasonings. Pour it over the rice and serve your family a great meal. On the second night, take the remaining rice, fry it in a skillet, and mix it with your favorite vegetables, and perhaps a can of shrimp or crab for another totally different rice-based meal. The leftover rice can also be saved and combined with turkey, chicken, or beef from previous meals to create different flavor combinations, including casseroles and soups. Rice makes a great staple for any meal preparation plan. In addition to its versatility, rice is also easy to freeze. After the cooked rice has been cooled in the fridge, it is easy to transfer to freezer bags and saved for future quick, easy, and healthy meals. No matter how short of time you are, it is still possible to create delicious, nutritious meals in no time. Making a week's worth of meals in only a few hours will give you more time to enjoy your food and your family. Cooking tips for healthier eating. Most people have heard that the new government guidelines recommend that all Americans eat at least 5 servings of fruits and vegetables every day. While that may seem like a lot, it is actually easier than you think to consume all the fruits and vegetables you need each and every day. Learning to cook with the many fruits and vegetables available at the local grocery store is an essential skill, and it is very important for those who hope to reach the 5-a-day guideline set down by the USDA. Just about everyone uses a microwave these days, and microwave ovens can make cooking with vegetables and fruits easy and fun. Using a microwave pressure cooker or microwave-proof bowl is a great way to quickly steam veggies. Cooking vegetables this way allows them to retain all their important nutrients. The microwave is also a great way to cook baked potatoes, and microwaved baked potatoes retain more of their natural moisture, therefore needing less of the fat-laden butter and sour cream. Combining free-steamed broccoli with that great baked potato gets you almost halfway to your goal of 5 servings of vegetables and fruits per day. The grill is another great way to meet your goal of 5 servings of fruits and vegetables every day. Why not use green peppers, red peppers, and pineapple chunks to create a delicious and colorful vegetable kebabs? Whether served with lean cuts of beef or by themselves, vegetable kebabs are a great treat for the whole family. Vegetables are best grilled over medium-hot coals. Those with a blender handy can make some wonderful smoothies with the great fresh fruit from the grocery store. Delicious smoothies can be made using peaches, nectarines, crushed ice, and fruit juice. For a quick fruit salad, simply open a can of mandarin oranges, add a banana, an apple, and strawberries, blueberries, or raisins. The total preparation time for this great fruit salad is all of 5 minutes. Fruit skewers are even easier to make than grilled vegetable skewers. Fruit skewers can easily be made by stacking strawberries, melon slices, grapes, and chunks of pineapples. A great dip can be made using non-fat plain or vanilla yogurt. Another great way to meet your 5-a-day fruit and vegetable goal is by making your own healthy salsa. There are some great recipes for salsa on the internet, using such great and healthy ingredients as tomatoes, avocados, red onions, mangoes, cilantro, and lime. For those looking for a fun way to enjoy fruits and vegetables, why not make some popsicles? Popsicles are not just for kids anymore, and pouring fruit or vegetable juice into a popsicle mold is a great way to make a delicious and nutritious snack. In addition, these healthy popsicles are a great way to get the kids interested in eating healthy at an early age. Since eating habits picked up in childhood can last a lifetime, that is very important. In addition to these great fruit and vegetable serving suggestions, there are other ways to create memorable meals using your 5-a-day criteria. For instance, adding broccoli florets, slices of carrots, cucumber slices, green peppers, and red peppers is a great way to add crunch and zest to a bland pasta salad. A plain old green salad can be perked up by including colorful fruits and vegetables like carrots, spinach leaves, tangerine slices, nectarines, grapes, slices of apples, pineapples, and raisins. Not only do these additions add beauty and drama to any salad, but they get you closer to your goal of 5 servings of fruits and vegetables a day. For a simple, inexpensive, and nutritious salad dressing, try such novel approaches as fruit juices, flavored vinegars, and homegrown herbs. Creating great-tasting salads is very important for healthy eating, and avoiding high-fat salad dressings is an important consideration for anyone concerned about their health. Another great way to ensure you eat plenty of vegetables and fruits is to add those vegetables and fruits to the foods you already eat. That can be as simple as adding green peppers and red peppers to your pizza, adding pineapple chunks to your shish kebabs, adding bananas to your cereal, or adding blueberries to your daily serving of yogurt. Using fish as part of a healthy eating plan. It is hard to beat fish and seafood for high protein and low fat. Fish has been shown in study after study to have a positive impact on health and to lower the risk of heart disease and other diseases. In addition, fish is delicious and easy to prepare. Many nutrition experts recommend eating fish at least once or twice every week. The most nutritious varieties of fish and those that contain the greatest amounts of heart-protecting omega-3 fatty acids tend to be those that live in cold ocean waters. These varieties of fish include salmon and sardines. The benefits of a fishy diet. Fish has long been thought to have a positive benefit on the heart. So far, the results of clinical studies have been inconclusive, but research into the heart-healthy effects of fish continues. No matter what the benefits, there is little doubt that fish is a healthy food, containing significant levels of protein and smaller amounts of fat and calories than other types of meat. As a matter of fact, fish is one of the best sources of protein there is. Everyone needs protein for building muscles and repairing damaged body tissues. In addition, protein plays a vital role in the growth of nails and hair, in hormone production, and in many other vital bodily processes. In addition to fish, many other animal-based products, such as meat, eggs, poultry, and dairy products, contain significant amounts of protein. Plant-based sources of protein exist as well, in nuts, beans, and lentils, among others. The key to getting sufficient protein in the diet is to balance the healthy effects of protein on the diet against the large amounts of fat and cholesterol that protein-rich foods often contain. The combination of high protein and low fat is one of the things that makes a diet rich in fish so appealing. With the exception of salmon, almost all commonly eaten varieties of fish are very low in fat, and even salmon contains lower levels of fat than many varieties of meats. In addition, fish is low in saturated fat, the type of fat that is most associated with heart disease and clogged arteries. Fish is low in unsaturated fat because of the nature of where and how they live. Instead of storing energy in the form of saturated fat as land animals do, fish store their fat in the form of polyunsaturated oils. That adaptation allows their bodies to function normally in the cool oceans and streams where they swim. It also makes them a great choice for anyone seeking to cut levels of saturated fat in the diet. For all these reasons, fish remains an important part of any low-fat, heart-healthy lifestyle. Substituting high-fat, greasy foods like hamburgers and ribs is a great way to make a change for healthy living. One note about fish and pollution, however. It is true that many fish caught in polluted waters contain high levels of mercury. While most commercially caught and grown fish is low in mercury, it is important for fishermen to limit their consumption of locally caught fish. Pregnant women are also advised to limit their intake of fish due to the potential harm to the baby. Fitting fish into your busy lifestyle. Many people avoid fish because they do not know how to prepare and cook it. While it is true that fish can present more of a challenge for the inexperienced, there are many recipes and cookbooks that make preparation easier. In addition, many packaged seafood products contain cooking tips and serving suggestions that take some of the mystery out of preparing a nutritious and delicious meal of fresh fish. Even those who do not cook, however, can enjoy the many benefits of fish in the diet. There are a number of canned seafood products on the market, including canned salmon, sardines, and the ever-popular tuna. So there is no reason fish cannot fit into your healthy eating plan. Making fish and seafood part of a healthy diet. Maximizing protein content while minimizing fat and calories is a goal of many people who are trying to lose weight, gain fitness, or just enjoy a healthier diet. There are few foods that combine low fat, low calories, and high protein the way fish and seafood do. In addition, the protective oils in many cold water fish are being studied for their possible role in preventing heart disease and lowering levels of cholesterol in the blood. In addition, fish dishes are delicious, easy to prepare, and often inexpensive. Many people have avoided buying more fish because they were unsure of how to cook and prepare it. While fish dishes can sometimes be a challenge, there are many recipes, both online and in cookbooks, that make it easier than ever to prepare fresh fish for yourself and your family. Many nutritionists recommend that everyone eat fish at least twice a week. Substituting low-fat, low-calorie fish dishes for more calorie-dense, fatty meats is a great way to lower the amount of total fat in your diet, and this can boost your level of fitness or help you lose weight. The amount of protein in fresh and frozen fish and seafood is very high, certainly comparable to higher fat sources like beef, pork, and lamb. And fish is generally thought to be a healthier choice, since all that protein comes with less fat and fewer calories. Everyone knows about the importance of protein in the diet for both children and adults. Protein is a vital building block of muscle, and it plays a role in repairing muscle damage, growing strong nails and hair, and other important bodily functions. While protein is found mainly in animal-based foods such as meat, poultry, seafood, eggs, and dairy products, there are plant-based sources of protein as well. These non-animal sources of protein include peanut butter, lentils, peas, and nuts. The downside to many protein-laden plant-based foods, however, is their high fat content. This is yet another feature that makes fish so appealing as a source of protein. Fish contains just as much protein as many of these higher fat, higher calorie sources. Eating fish provides, shall we say, a greater protein bang for the buck than many other sources. You may have heard that salmon contains a lot of fat, and it is true that salmon does contain more fat than many other fish. Compared to high-fat meats like sausage and bacon, however, salmon is still a relatively low-fat source of protein. Like other fatty foods, however, it is important for those watching their fat intake to limit their consumption of salmon. One advantage fish has over other types of meats is the type of fat it contains. Most meats contain saturated fats, which are solid at room temperature. Unlike cattle, pigs, and other land animals, the fat in fish is of the polyunsaturated variety. Polyunsaturated fats are liquid at room temperature, and they are healthier fats for the people who consume them. Saturated fats are thought to play a greater role in heart disease, stroke, and hardening of the arteries. That is why healthy cooking typically involves the use of polyunsaturated fats, such as canola oil and olive oil, instead of saturated fats, such as beef lard and butter. Many people worry about the level of pollution in general, and mercury contamination in particular in fish. While it is true that polluted waters are of some concern when it comes to fish, seafood products are actually quite safe to eat. In addition, many types of fish, like salmon and sardines, are farm-raised, and their diet and environment is strictly controlled. It is recommended, however, that fishermen and fisherwomen limit the amount of their catch that is eaten if they live near a polluted river or stream. The local fishing and hunting authority usually issues guidelines for eating fish in areas where pollution is a problem. There is no doubt that a healthy eating lifestyle is an important key to a healthy body. We hope that the tips listed above will help you get started on the road to a healthier you.